What to do, what to do. I know I've got to paint that cowl today. Have the bad buddies been good? Whoa, going for 100 views in less than 24 hours almost? And 5 commenters? Enthusiastic? Well, I suppose they've all been pretty good. All right, let's go to the cave. Oh, hey, bad buddies, you startled me there. hot cappuccino. My wife always serves it to me in this mug. I got the mug for her because I was expressing that I love her, but she thinks it's supposed to be for me. I guess I didn't get that one right. Well, that phone's not ringing. I suppose, since I was gonna go there anyway, I can take you to the workshop and I can show you how to paint a latex cowl. A really strange color. How should we get there today? Should I take the pole? Should I take the chair? I could walk. Oh, that's kind of boring. I don't want to break my mug. Maybe I'll walk. So, I'm working, of all things, with a bat buddy from Ireland. And, you know, I need to change my, attire. I forgot. I can't paint in a nice shirt. I gotta get back to my regular standards. The bat change lever will help. Yeah, we all know about Alfred. But fortunately, I have another cure. It kinda works for everything I do. Ah, blew all the foam off my cappuccino. Anyway, on to the purposes at hand. I'm gonna paint a cowl today for somebody from Ireland. Now, what would you think? Yeah, thank goodness it's not gonna be pink. But what color do you think they'd want? Green? Yeah, that'd be bad. But this is gonna be burgundy of all things. It's better than pink. But it'll give me a chance to show you what I was gonna do anyway, since you've been extra good bat buddies, and show you how you paint a latex cowl a different color, and how easy it is, and how you mix the color, and whatever else I decide to do. Eric, you were right, I always wing it. I love winging it. You know why? Because I love being creative. It's an outlet. And I'm going to wing it again. I always wing it. If I knew what I was going to do, it wouldn't be fun. Like I say, this is all about fun, bad buddies. Make it fun and I'll want to do it more. I'm going to do it anyway. Question is, do I waste my time making it on the video and editing it and whatever else, the goofy stuff, or do I just do it and keep it to myself? Yes, that's boring. A lot better than it was. Last sip. No, this isn't my wrapping paper leftover. I picked this up on my jog today. Came home, cut off the ends, putting this away for next year. I gotta clear this place off because we gotta take this cowl and make it burgundy. It's really not original. It's cuts only. John Schneider does the same thing. You guys John Schneider fans? So, what do we do? I have never painted this cowl in latex before. I've used Plasti Dip. I've showed you some of the techniques. I'm gonna need a brush. And I'm gonna need some latex. Some untinted latex. I'm gonna need tint. Redundancy. Having more than you need is a good thing. Now, I always talk about how I try to stay on the cheap, but when something's paid for up front, I do it differently. I've got 5 different colors. You can't really just buy burgundy. We didn't talk about exactly what hue it had to be, but that doesn't matter, because even if you hit it exact, latex is gonna cure darker, and over time it's gonna get darker, especially if you put it in the sun. So we're gonna aim a little bit bright, a little bit lighter, knowing we could always make it darker. We didn't talk about the exact hue anyway, just general burgundy. What's the difference between burgundy and maroon? Basically, the main difference is maroon has yellow and some brown tones in it, but burgundy is just the perfect hue of the perfect red and the perfect blue. Well, I couldn't get the perfect red and the perfect blue. I've got phthalo blue, bulletin red, a really old phthalo blue, magenta, and red oxide. Now, obviously, you can't use the red oxide alone because it's not going to be the right hue. But I'm going to put a little bit of that in, I think. But I'm not going to go and use these expensive ones if I can make the color with two tubes instead of five. I will. Why? Because they're all returnable. And I only buy supplies as I need them. That's the one place where I don't skimp. I use the highest quality medical grade latex, and I use high quality everything else. It's only the junk stuff that I do for my own personal usage around here and whatever I use in my personal life that I talk to you about how I get by. There's a time to not be cheap. And when you're doing a piece, that's the time. So, this cowl is prepared. Let's talk about mixing up the latex. I've got a bunch of other things I've got to do for this exact same Bat Buddy. And so I'm going to go and mix up an entire 2.5 gallons of untinted latex and tin it. I'm not going to tell you everything I do, but normally I know exactly the amount to put in for a 5 gallon. Today, I'm just going to put in half that amount. So I'm going to start working on getting that color to where I think it should be. So I'm going to start out with... could mix it in here. Nah, I'm getting in trouble. One of these. And I'm gonna say that I'm almost definitely gonna use the magenta. That's pretty doggone close. Got a little bit of white in it. Maybe more than I wanted to have. Let's do this scientifically. Let's weigh this. I'm gonna go ahead and use, let's see. I'm gonna start off, I wanna do a formula, because if there's any reason I get it wrong, I wanna know what I have. And if there's any reason I have to do the whole thing again, or I have to have more and I wanna match it, I wanna know what I did, okay? So I'm gonna go with 5 ounces of the magenta, which I think is pretty close. You know, the cup. All right, I'm gonna go, I'm gonna go with some bulletin red. You know, we did a 2D design project in art school about 40 years ago. And it was the funnest project. You would never realize this, but I'm gonna tell you about it. We had this huge book of all these Pantone colors and everything. And the 2D design teacher said, now, here's your assignment for tomorrow. And everybody goes, oh, what's it gonna be? Real simple one. But you think it's simple, but it's not. It says, I want everybody to come in tomorrow and I've picked 3 colors. The perfect red, the perfect blue, and the perfect yellow. And we go, ha, 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 yeah, right. We're all gonna come in with the same thing. What a waste of our time. Probably some, had some other work that night too. But here's the amazing thing, folks. We're all artists. We all, you'd think, would know what the perfect colors are. And do you know that everybody in that class of probably 30 people had chosen different colors? Yeah, so this is not an exact science. Unless you use like an exact Pantone number and say, I need that to be that, and you can't do that with latex anyway. It's gonna be what it's gonna be. So, first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take some of this red, bulletin red, because this is too pinkish, it's got too much white in it. I'm gonna mix these two together and see what I've got. Well, my guess, I believe, is very accurate. What I've got is what I want in the first place, burgundy. So, with 5 ounces of magenta to 3 ounces of bulletin red, I've got the color I'm going for. What I'm gonna do now is, I'm not gonna make the full amount yet. I'm gonna figure out how much of this would I need for the 2.5 gallons, and I'm gonna take and tint just the amount I need to paint this cowl. So this is a test, but I'm gonna enlarge it later when I do my other items, so I wanna make sure everything I do is accurate so that when I make it larger, it's the same amount of tint per latex. And then if I like the way this comes out, then the other items will be good too. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'll get back to you in just a little while. Okay, back. As I was saying, we do everything scientifically around here. I needed to have the latex dry so I could check the sample color, and so I needed the exact right time. And I figured that was just about the length of time it would take to take my daughter to In-N-Out Burger. I was wrong, but fortunately, there's a little area on here that is dry, even though the main thing's not, and I'm gonna count that as the color. I'm just gonna dive in here, and knowing that this first coat can be covered by the next coats, that ain't the color, but it doesn't dry like that. I've looked at this with the lights on and different things. Here's what we're gonna do. This is a textured cowl. The most important thing you want to realize with a textured cowl like this, it's got this leathery texture in it. I've talked about this in other videos. It was done with a texture stamp and careful working with various tools to get that. I don't want to cover any of that up. Now, I could have done the whole thing in this color, but if I do this right, it won't matter. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to work it in there really well. I'm going to do this in several coats, okay? So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and put it on there. This is all clean, never been armor-alled. And I know that the black's gonna show through a little bit, but I actually want it to show through a little bit because what's gonna happen is the latex is gonna shrink. Latex shrinks about up to 20%. And when you're on something that's already the shape it's gonna be, it doesn't shrink. What it does is it just gets really tightly into there. Now, if I wanna make sure that I have all this quality of this texture showing up, I have to make sure that I do this a certain way because I don't wanna lose it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna force it into the deep down areas of all the texture first by putting on a nice liberal coat like this. Once I've done this, I'm gonna go ahead and lift it off, making sure there's not too much. Now, one of the ways I lift it off is I go a little bit further and clean my brush down here a little bit. And I'll do this in sections. And what I'll do is once I know there's not anything really left on my brush, I'll go ahead and lift that off. Now I'm gonna see the black showing through, but I want to see the black showing through because on the second coat, and maybe the third coat, we'll just scrape the tops of all those little valleys of texture. And that way, we won't lose the texture. In fact, if you want to accentuate the texture, what you can do is, you can continue to add coats lightly, dry brushing, and you can actually accentuate the texture. So what I'm doing right now is I'm making sure that my base coat is on there, down in the crevices of all the texture. I'm making sure that there's nothing more on there than the crevices. So all the surface tops are being taken off. Now, I'm not gonna do this whole thing because it'll get boring, but I'm just giving you the idea of what I'm doing. Now I'm gonna go ahead and just do the whole thing and we're gonna see what happens. And we're not gonna see this on this video. I need to get this done, I need to keep it short, and we'll talk about how it comes out probably in an upcoming video. That'll be the video for today. Tune in again soon and we'll see how this and other items come out for this particular Bat Buddy. And I can talk you through what I've done and how it turned out and if I had to make any changes. And that'll be another video for another day. I had to show you this. Yes, we have a pink cowl, and it's totally wet, but hey, I gotta have a picture of a pink cowl. So now we have it. There was one other thing I did. In case there was any texture left behind from the brush, I didn't want that. I didn't want a brush line at all to be shown. So what I've done is, I've taken and blotted the entire thing with a rag so that the topmost portion of all the texture is off, and all the deep pockets of the texture hopefully will remain untouched. Now, if there is any texture added to it, my goal is to not have very much, it'll be a uniform texture and it will be a blotty type texture rather than a brush stroke. So this was the final stage and I thought I'd turn the camera on one more time to show you this final stage and show you what a pink cowl looks like. Yeah, we already know from the Mad Hatter, I believe it was, yes. What's the name of that? Wait, my quick reference book. Episode 69 and 70, The Contaminated Cowl, The Mad Hatter Runs Afoul. In case you were checking for fact checks back at home. A very handy book, very dog-eared, very used. Okay, that's it for today, guys. Paul Roberts, Artsy One. Talk to you later, Bat Buddies. And this won't be pink when we come back. I forgot to tell you also, it's somewhat see-through, so it's gonna take a number of layers. But the good news is, it all went down in real tight, and all the texture's there. See, no brush strokes, just real nice texture. So we're on the right track.